Look it.
You would do anything for her.
Oh gosh, yeah. Yeah, absolutely. Brinley was born 13 weeks early. My husband and I, but mostly I, created some bad sleeping patterns.
We spend a third of our lives sleeping, but if you think about it, how much do you really know about it?
She co-slept with us until she was, oh my goodness, almost a year. Our problem wasn't her going to sleep. Our problem was her waking up in the middle of the night. That was the hardest too, was listening to her cry. As a parent, that's the one thing that you hate.
You don't think about sleep until you're not sleeping well.
Oh, where'd they go?
And that's where I come in, and I'm able to help families and adults figure out what their trigger, you know, what's happening, why it's happening, and how to overcome those issues so that sleep now becomes another thing that you can take for granted again. Before your mom, you're going, how hard could it be? And then I had my son. It's really hard. And that's where living that gave me a new perspective. By doing what I do now, I'm able to help families not experience the same struggles that I did in that respect. Like they're able to enjoy those really special moments with their kids and not be sleep deprived or exhausted.
Over there.
Katie's here with us this morning to answer some of your sleep questions. I wish I would have known you a few years ago and my son wouldn't have slept. Thanks for being here today. You know, a lot of people are telling us online that they can fall asleep, but their real issue is staying asleep. So do you have any advice for them?
I do. You know, something that people, I think, really underestimate is the power of our environment and how we set ourselves up for sleep. You know, we love our smart screens, we love our phones, our tablets and TVs, but they're really not that helpful for us in terms of falling asleep. They emit blue light, which inhibit our body's ability to produce melatonin, which melatonin is used to help us fall asleep, but if you don't have enough melatonin in your system to sleep through the night, you're going to wake up.
Huh, so it doesn't stop you from falling asleep, it helps you wake up later. Huh, I didn't know that.
Melatonin helps us fall asleep in terms that we release a huge burst of it and last through the night. But if you're shorting the amount that you have, mm-hmm. or you have extra cortisol levels in your bloodstream because you're going to bed too late and things like that, all of that works together to against you and makes you wake up when you're trying to sleep. So my best tip is to, one, look at your schedule and routine. Make sure you're not looking at your phone or watching TV right before you go to sleep.
Hard to do.
I know it's hard to do, but it really is effective. It really works. Such a simple thing to do. Another thing that I tell people is that if you're laying in bed and you're awake and you're stressing, get out of bed. Commit to 15 or 20 minutes of a relaxing, quiet activity that you can do in low light. It doesn't require, you know, your phone. You read a book, do yoga, meditation. I've had people do reorganizing their spice rack.
Wow.
Really, the idea is taking that stress off, go do something simple and quiet, and then get back in bed.